After placing all board modules on the multi-board schematic sheet, we will need to connect them. Altium Designer has four different types of connections to choose from, and these can be found in the Place section of the main menu. Direct connection is used to connect boards directly to each other via a connector like DDR or PCIe boards. The wire connection type is represented as individual wires between the pins of each module entry connector. The cable connection is used when the boards are connected by a regular or ribbon cable with wires following a strict order, similar to a direct connection. The harness type connection is used to place cables with heterogeneous signals into one cable. It also allows you to connect one board to several other boards at the same time. All of these connection placement tools are also available in the active bar. If you've made connections in a schematic, this process will seem familiar to you. In order to place a connection, first select its type, then simply connect the entries of the modules together. Notice that each connection has a unique designator and a label at the beginning and end of each. The connections between child project modules are not necessarily a pin-to-pin match, particularly when a connector is split in sections that are wired to different PCB modules. To edit or correct the pin net matches between a module interconnection, select the connection in the workspace and then change the from to assignments as required in the properties panel's connections list entries. In contrast to direct and wire connections, cable and harness connection types require additional configuration after placement. When a connection is selected, the entry section appears in the properties panel, which is used to match and configure the connectors to match those components already placed on the sheet. After the connection is created, the part column is empty by default. To specify the appropriate component, click the ellipsis next to the appropriate entry. Note that you can only select a component from a local library. You can quickly create a local library that contains all the components used in a single project. To do this, open one of the project schematic sheets and then apply the Design Make Integrated Library tool. To ensure correct connectivity of all nets included in a connection, you should define a part for each connected entry. You can also define designators for the connection entries or hide them. After assigning the parts, you can see a list of all associated nets in the connections section. However, in some cases, the connections list may not show up after the assignment. You can update the connection list manually. To do this, first select No Mated Entry from the drop-down menu in the From section, then return it to the original entry. After that, all connections will be displayed in the list. To more clearly show the connection of one module to several others, you can logically split one connector into several entries. To split a connector in this way, first select the module on which it is located. Then select the connector to be split in the entry section of the properties panel and click the split button. Expand the list and select the nets that you want to separate into a separate entry, then click accept. After that, a new entry will appear with the split off nets. Repeat this for all missing parts to complete the remaining connections. You can see a summary of all the connections between boards using the Connection Manager. For more information on using this tool to resolve net conflicts between boards, please check out the next video.